For software engineering online session number 6 on module 1 chapter 4. Myself Jagdisha, associate professor, department of computer science, Canara Engineering College. So in this session we'll cover requirement specification, requirement design, and the requirement elicitation and analysis process. So requirement specification, the process of writing the user and the system requirements in the requirement documents. User requirements have to be understandable by the end users and the customers who do not have technical background. System requirements are more detailed requirements and may include more technical information. The requirements may be part of contract for the system development, and it is therefore important that these are as complete as possible. So in the previous video session we have seen about the identifying the functional and non-functional requirements of the software, as well as the requirement document of the software design. So once the software document has been ready, it is being processed for the next team, that is for the specification. So what are the documents is been given by the customer, is been written by the software engineers for the next team to be delivered. So they're going to specify the user requirement as well as system requirements in a document, requirement document. So in the user requirements have to be understandable by the customers who do not have the technical background. So software has been designed and is been handed over to the customer. So customer doesn't know the technical knowledge of the software or the software in which tool it has been designed. System requirements are more detailed requirements and may include more technical information. In the system requirements, it may be a hardware requirement, what type of RAM, as well as ROM, as well mother something like related to the requirement or system requirements, which tool they have been used, whether it is a speed of the RAM, etc. Some information. So that the requirement should be given in detail to the customer. So ways of writing a system requirement specification. So system requirement specification, so how they are able to write it in a different ways are being discussed in this session or in this slide. In the notation, natural languages is nothing but simple like English statement. So whatever the requirement is being said by the customer, this is the way in the natural language we can express it and write written using sentences. And structural natural languages, in the structural natural languages, something like you can see your algorithm. So input, output, and description, as well as in variables, something like it is being given step by step procedure, and they have to specify the requirements. So requirements are written in natural languages as a standard format. The standard format will be there as per as the customer requirement, or some templates will be there. In that template, the requirement of the customers will be keep on filling. Or you can see your whenever you visit for the any of the clinic or any of the hospital or any of the colleges, the initially they give one sheet that is in the standard format. You should fill your name, father name, occupation, date of birth, etc. This is what the standard format. In that standard format, is been provided even in the software engineers to fill the customer's requirements. So next, design description languages. So this is approach uses languages like a programming languages. So there are some programming languages also available for the requirement specification to be filled by the software engineer as per the customer requirements. There's abstract features to be specified the requirements by defining an operational model of the system. So there are some of the models also there, depending upon the previous models, requirement of the customers can show the system which is already available. So little bit of changes can be do it in the description languages. So this is another way to give the specification. And fourth one is a graphical notation. Graphical notation, something like a text annotation, text annotations are used to define the functional requirements for the system. Something like UML, use cases diagram, sequence diagram, context model diagram, as well as class diagram, something related to that. So this we'll be studying in the third module. So we'll see how to write a UML, that is use case diagram, sequence diagram, related to the specification of the requirements. And the fifth one is a mathematical specification. And these are concepts like a finite state machine. This also, you can, you'll be studying this part in the fifth semester, the subject called finite state automata. So where you're going to, as per as customer requirements, whether you're able to design the product or will be end up with some problem. So easily we'll be able to do it with the help of the mathematical notation, and we can satisfy whether we can satisfy the customer requirements or not with the help of the mathematical notation also. So these are the five ways of writing the requirement specification. One is natural languages like simple English statement, and structured natural languages where this is something like a standard format will be there, or template. In that we have to keep on filling the requirements. Design description language is something programmatic subject, programmatic languages will be designed to fill the requirement of the specification. Graphical notation like UML and use case diagrams are used to design the specification of the requirement. And last one is a mathematical notation like a finite state automata or finite state machine, whether we are able to design the product or not has been decided in the mathematical specification also. So these are the various requirement specification we have seen in the software engineer. Next, requirements and design. In principles, requirements should state what the system should do, and the design should decide how it does this. So in the requirements and design, what system should do as per as customer requirements, whether the system is doing as per as customer requirements data is being seen in the requirement design. In practice, requirements and designs are inseparable. A system architecture may be designed to structure the requirements. The system may be interoperate with other system that generate the design requirements. The use of specific architecture to satisfy non-functional requirements may be domain requirements. This may be consequences of a regulatory requirements. So there are natural language specification. Requirements are written as a natural language sentences using diagrams and tables. Used for writing a requirements because it is expressive and universal languages. This means that the requirements can be understood by the user and the customer very easily. So something, one example is better English languages where it is easy to understandable, as well as it is universal languages. Guidelines for writing a documents. So some invite a standard format and use it for all requirements. So some standard format will be designed. So for all type of the project, it is used for all requirements. Use languages in a consistent way. Use shell for mandatory requirements, should for desirable requirements. Use text highlighting to identify the key parts of the requirements. So customers says some of the fields or some of the requirements that is very important in his project. So that type of requirement, which is very important as per as customer stresses, so software engineers uses a text highlighting. You should highlight the text which is more important for the customer. Avoid use of computer jargon, that is computer misuse should be avoided, and include an explanation. Wherever the explanation is required, it is better to give a proper explanation as per as a requirement necessary. Problems, what are with the natural languages? So lack of clarity, requirement confusion, requirements amalgamation. So lack of clarity, so it's difficult without making a document difficult to read. So difficult without making the document difficult to read. So software engineers or maybe customer in his own languages, he'll be keep on writing the requirement. So where there is a lack of clarity for the software engineers to understand. So requirement confusion. So functional and non-functional requirements tend to be mixed up. So some customers doesn't know about the which is a functional and which is non-functional requirement. So even that also makes a confusion for the software engineers. So requirement amalgamation, several different requirements may be expressed together. So something like you are hitting all that is breakfast, lunch, dinner at one time. So with something will be mess up and where it is something like this only, requirement amalgamation. So expressing each and everything at a single point of time where it will be difficult to understand the problems by the software engineers. So requirement engineering process. The process used for requirement engineering depend on application domain, the people involved and the organization developing the requirements. However, there are a number of activities common to all the process. One is requirement elicitation, another one is requirement analysis, third one is requirement validation, and fourth one is requirement management. In practice, requirement engineering is an iterative activity, something like it's a keep on repeating till the product get ready. So it is an iterative process in which the process are interleaved. So you can see the spiral diagram. One is requirement specification, requirement validation, requirement elicitation, and requirement document. So it is a process is iterative till you get the correct product. So in the requirement specification, that is business requirement specification by the customer, in that identifying the user requirement as well as system requirements, and the validation as per as the requirement specification, whether it has been designed or not, feasibility study, whether that it is financially able to design the product with the existing technology is been identified. If it is able, then the process has been repeated, or it is process starts working. And if any problems occurs, any that is able to rectify with the help of the several there is protocols and designing the product as early as possible for the customer requirements. And the requirement validation as per as customer requirements, tested the data according to the customer data, whether the output is coming or not is been checked, and releases the product with the help of with the proper document. With the proper document, it has been designed and it's been handed over to the next team. So requirement elicitation and analysis is the next team. That is a requirement, sometimes called requirement elicitation or requirements discovery. It involves the technical staffs working with customers to find about the application domain, the services that the system should provide, and the system operational constraints. May involve end users, managers, engineers involved in maintenance, domain experts, trade unions, and all of this we call as stakeholders. So something like related stakeholders of colleges is a student, stakeholder of colleges is staff, principal, as well as teaching staff, non-teaching staff, parents of the students, etc. are all the stakeholders to the college. The same way, stakeholders for the software engineering is software is managers, engineers, and domain expert, and the maintaining team and selling team are all the stakeholders for the software. So problems of the requirement analysis. Stakeholders is nothing but the persons who may be managers, engineers, or even a client. Stakeholders do not know what they really want. Though as far as this statement, the stakeholders is nothing but the customer or client. Stakeholders express the requirements in their own terms. So something like I want a software where I can enter the student's database. This is what the statement is given by the customer. So in his own terms he says, so for the software engineers it will be very difficult to understand the concept, what he is telling, how to design, how for how many field it is required, some or something like this. It will be mess up with this problems. And different stakeholders may have a conflict requirements. So organization and political factors may influence the system requirements. The requirements change during the analysis process. So during the analysis process also, some customer says, no, I don't want this type of information or this type of application. I want some other where I can enter something like, if you take it an example of an online library system, where he has been told to design only for technical books. So it's very, when it is designing, why can't you add one more, there is non-technical group or non-technical book to search. So this is something like, he comes and says, since he wants only for technical book to be searched, so later stage he says, no, it is required for non-technical book also, please design for that also. Something during analyzing process also, there will be some changes happens. So these are the problems in the requirement analysis we've seen. Software engineers work with range of system stakeholders to find out about the application domain, the services, the system should provide the required performances, hardware constraints, and system. These are the, there is a range of the system we have seen. And stages, requirement discovery, classification and organization, prioritization, negotiation, and specification. So here, you can see the process. One is discovery and requirement classification, organization, requirement prioritization, and negotiation, and requirement specification. So this is also something like circular diagram for the elicitation and the analysis process. So we'll see one by one here. In the requirement discovery, interacting with the stakeholders to discover their requirements. So as far as the customer sits and he says what are the requirement is required. So instead of, if he gives on his own idea, it is better to give sit with the customer, and as far as customer requirements, it is better to take the requirement. So domain requirement also be discovered at this stage. So domain requirement, whether it is a standalone system or it is a web-based application, or which type of tool, what type of systems requirements has to be used, etc., has been identified and discovered in the requirement discovery. Second one is a requirement classification and organization. Groups related requirements and organize them to coherent clusters. So classification and organization. So there'll be one product has to be designed. So for that it is required a specification team, design team, verification team, as well as evolution team. So it has been classified by the in the elicitation analysis process itself. So that comes under this classification organization requirement. Prioritization and negotiation. Prioritizing requirements and resolving the requirement conflicts. So if any of the problems occurs during the development, so for that there should be a separate team, negotiation, prioritization. So prioritization for which requirement it should be given important, and how to solve that requirement should be, because the, at the, during the development there should not be a conflict. So for that, even in the elicitation analysis time itself, the team is be designed. At last, specification requirements are documented and input to the next round of the spiral. So requirements are documented and input into the next round of the spiral. So this team will be doing the documented and it has been done to the given to the next round if there is any problem occurs in the requirement. So this is what the we seen in the requirement analysis process: requirement discovery, requirement classification and organization, requirement prioritization and negotiation, and requirement specification. This is cycle keep on repeating till the proper output comes. Next, problems of the requirement elicitation. What are the problems? Stakeholders do not know what they really want. Stakeholders express requirement in their own terms. Different stakeholders may have a conflict requirements. We'll stop here. We'll move on to the next slide, next session in the next class. Thanking you.